This is All India Radio. In the program Spotlight, now we bring you a discussion on minimum support price, MSP, and agricultural reforms. The participants are Ashok Tandon, political analyst, and Sanjeev Mukherjee, journalist.
A lot of people are talking a lot of things about the agriculture reform. And one big question mark is that whether the MSP mechanism will be anyway hampered due to these reforms. And a lot of farmers are fearing this. How do you look at this?
Now, since the agitation has entered into fourth week, the government as well as the BJP, now they have launched kind of an offensive to explain to the people directly and also talk directly to the farmers. And therefore, a massive campaign was launched today to organize farmers' meet in different parts of the country. And the Prime Minister himself today addressed the farmers, of course, virtual rally, farmers of Madhya Pradesh. And then he explained everything, what the issues are and what the opposition is trying to make political capital out of it. And in that context, he listed all the welfare schemes which the government has launched for the farmers' benefit. And then he went on to explain the PM Kisan scheme which his government launched will be giving about 75,000 crore to farmers every year. That means about ₹7 lakh crore in 10 years. So transfer directly to farmers' bank account. No leakages, no commissions. But then he said, unfortunately, the opposition parties are creating fear among farmers. They will lose land, but instead the politicians are making political land for themselves. So these things, he said, are like, shedding crocodile tears. And the opposition leaders are becoming heartless on this farmers' issue. So the Prime Minister's language was quite, in fact, confronting the opposition parties and also trying to explain directly to the farmers that the amount of money they have been talking about sending is never reaching the farmers. That was the position earlier when the other governments were there, and the farmer thought that the entire loan would be waived now. And you know what they have received? He said 2 years ago the Madhya Pradesh farmers were promised the land waiver scheme. What happened to that? So then he said, if you look at the situation today, there are no reports of shortage of urea. It means his government has been working honestly to alleviate the sufferings of the farmer. The Modi government has stopped black marketing, took stringent measures. It's a nail on the corruption, and we have ensured that urea would go to the farmer's field. Now, all these points were covered by the Prime Minister. And then he said, what was the situation of urea 7 to 8 years ago, overnight, whether the farmers had to stand in queues, etc. So, like that, he went on to say that farmers have been given Kisan credit card. Earlier, they were not available to them. But we changed the rules to make Kisan credit card available to all farmers across the country. In fact, he was castigating the Kamal Nath government in Madhya Pradesh. So then he said the agitation against the center's new farm law is farmers are not understanding the benefits which these three farm laws are going to give them. So this is a part of the appeal which the Prime Minister has earlier been making, that listen to what the Agriculture Minister is offering and also study his open letter which Narendra Singh Tomar has written to the farmers and like that. So that is the position right now, and BJP is now organizing Kisan rallies in different parts of the country. Smriti Irani is going to address, Sanjeev Balyan will be addressing, Krishan Pal Gujar will be addressing in Agra, Smriti Irani will be addressing in Meerut, like that. And moreover, the party has also decided to organize Kisan Chopal in 718 districts. So all these measures are now to educate the farmers and also enlighten the people by and large why the farmers are not agreeing to the proposals of the government. Because ultimately what they wanted was an assurance on MSP and mandis. Both these count, assurance has been given. The government has said even to the extent that they are giving to give assurance on MSP in writing and also willing to amend whatever provision needs to be changed in consultation with the farmers. After all, whatever position the government has taken now is the outcome of the continuous dialogue which was happening. So many rounds have taken place. But now, apparently under pressure from some political parties, the farmers are not even willing to resume the dialogue. So that is the position.
My question is that there is a massive outreach on part of the government also to explain the benefits of the laws to the farmers. Prime Minister today also and earlier also he has been saying that the laws are beneficial. Do you think it will cut ice with the farmers when they should come back to the negotiating table and discuss all outstanding issues, right?
You know, some farmers or organizations have already come in support of this. Because the Federation of Indian FPOs and Aggregators, FIFA, they have extended their support to the government's farm laws. After meeting the Agriculture Minister Narendra Singh Tomar, said that, and there are so many other groups are also from Haryana, Uttarakhand and UP, they are also coming in support of the government stand after getting proper briefing from the minister. So if large section from the rest of the country is not agitating, and even the states where the farmers are agitating, like state of Haryana, Uttar Pradesh and Uttarakhand, their farmer organizations are understanding and realizing the gravity of the situation. Why can't the farmers who are agitating, particularly from Punjab, are not willing to listen to the government? After all, they were the one holding negotiations with the government. They put across certain suggestions. The government considered them. And government has now given in writing that this is exactly what is on the table. Now they are willing to do this, this, this. But now they are, you know, adamant that the government must repeal these laws. That was not the demand initially. The initial demand of the agitating farmers was that we want an assurance on writing, in writing on MSP and about the mandi. On those scores, government has now said they are willing to do that. So therefore, I think the deadlock is leading nowhere. In a democracy, the best option for resolving all issues is dialogue. And exactly what has been achieved from the point of view of the farmers by the government giving certain assurances is also through dialogue. So I think somewhere it appears that certain opposition political parties are now not allowing the farmers to withdraw their agitation and come, or at least come back to the negotiating table to resolve the pending issues. That is the question.
The Supreme Court has also stepped in and it is also looking at the whole gamut of issues. It also talked about forming a committee to comprising of the farmers, the government and everything. How do you see this development? Is it a move forward?
Supreme Court, first of all, let's be clear, is that they have declined to intervene into the farmers' protest. And they say that, of course, they have upheld the right of the farmers to agitate. But then the Supreme Court also said that the talks must be held to resolve the issues. Because blockade of Delhi roads, etc., is not going to solve the problem. Because that is causing inconvenience. So therefore, Supreme Court said that we are of the view that at this stage, that the farmers' protest should be allowed to continue without impediment and without any breach of the people's right to movement. Now that must be understood and realized by the agitating farmers. Then they said that the committee thing, apparently they have not said anything. They have just exploring the possibility. Because the PILs which have been filed before the Supreme Court has said that let the farmers also become party to the petition. Only then we can entertain it. So this appeal, firstly to farmers, okay, we uphold your right to protest, but it should not be blocking the way. But at the same time, dialogue must be resumed. And then they said that they have in fact asked the Attorney General, can we facilitate the dialogue process by forming a committee of the agitating farmers and the government representatives, etc. Now on that, I think the farmers also have to take a call on that, whether they will be listening to the Supreme Court proposal or not. There has been no response from the agitating farmers about on the Supreme Court taking these issues. And I think now, maybe in a couple of days, the government also will respond to what the Supreme Court has been suggesting. But at the same time, the farmers organization will also have to, you know, at least take cognizance of what the Supreme Court is offering. So if they don't listen to the Supreme Court, then you never know how the Supreme Court is going to react to the entire situation.
Another thing which is coming out with the Prime Minister also repeatedly said is that procurement has gone up in this last 5-6 years of the Narendra Modi government compared to the previous years. So, and it has also, number of crops also initially procured has also gone up. How do you see this as a message to the farmers?
See, if you go by the media reports based on the official facts, there has been a bumper purchase of the Kharif procurement. under the MSP. Now, if MSP is giving so much comfort to the farmers, which is not going to be done away with, then the result is that the fact remains that the MSP is still working, and that is how the procurement is taking place. And at the same time, we have to see that recently, in a couple of days back, the government announced 3,500 crore benefit for the farmers in the sugarcane farming. And that is going to help over 5 crore people. So all these welfare schemes, one thing I would like to say is that no government, whether it is the BJP or any other government, cannot pass any law which is detrimental to the interest of the farmers. And that is the situation in India. So how could any government, particularly which has been making so many concessions and bringing out so many schemes for the welfare of the farmers, could enact laws which are not in the interest of the farmers. But having said that, if the farmers have any reservation, which they had, and they started dialogue, why can't they resume the dialogue if they have any reservations left? So, and these situation can be controlled. But not trying to, you know, threatening that the agitation will be intensified, we will block the road, toll plazas will be blocked and all that. I don't think it's in the larger interest of democracy, because there are also very disturbing intelligence reports that some elements are also trying to infiltrate into the agitation. You never know how the situation will develop, because they don't believe in democracy, they don't believe in rule of law. And if the public order is disturbed, then I think ultimately the blame will be lying on the farmers' leaders, who are by and large peaceful. And they are all very reasonable people. So therefore, it is their responsibility also to ensure that no such elements are allowed to either enter or even trying to take over the agitation. But the farmers are denying it, but there are very clear indications like the posters and the banners which are being raised at the farmers' agitation site, and also the intelligence reports. So therefore, all these put together, I think there is no other option for the farming agitation leaders to come back on the negotiation table and try to resolve all pending issues, because a lot of issues have already been resolved. But simultaneously, I think another very significant step was taken by the agriculture minister, was writing an open letter to the farmers. So this letter of Narendra Singh Tomar is not only for the agitating farmers, but it is for the entire farming community in the country. Those who are just silent spectators, they are mute spectators, they can't play any very positive role. So he has addressed those farmers directly. I think it's a direct dialogue with the farming community, in which he has given all kinds of assurance. He has dispelled all kinds of apprehensions of farmers, step by step, everything he has discussed and what the government has already done. And then he says that even whatever is left, please come back to the negotiating table and we will resolve this issue. And that doesn't mean they should be blocking the roads and all that. So they should call off their strike. If they don't want to call off the agitation, they should at least come back to the negotiating table. That is exactly what the open letter has said. But he has also accused the opposition party of spreading falsehood about the new laws. And then he said that they are trying to fire the gun from the shoulders of the farmer agitation, the people who are farming. But at the same time, he has appealed to farmers again and again not to fall prey to these white lies being spread by certain opposition parties.
Hopefully, sir, in the coming days, things will improve and the farmers will see reason and come back to the negotiating table and just explain that all outstanding issues can be solved on only discussion is the forum and discussion is the way forward to go in a democracy. And let's hope that everything settles down to the best of things involved.
Certainly, and, because that is the only way forward. You know, in a democracy, as Supreme Court has also held, that dialogue is the only way. And we also want, the Supreme Court also wants the matters to be resolved through dialogue. And for that, they are willing to facilitate. But farmers should also agree to that. And if they agree, obviously, Supreme Court will facilitate a dialogue. Maybe they may go for a committee with the representatives of the agitating farmers and the government, and also maybe certain agriculture experts. So let's hope for the best.
Thank you for joining us.
Thank you very much.
You are listening to a discussion on minimum support price, MSP, and agricultural reforms. The participants were Ashok Tandon, political analyst, and Sanjeev Mukherjee, journalist. This program was produced and presented by the News Services Division of All India Radio. You can listen to it on our mobile app, News on Air. This program is also available on our website, newsonair.com. You may email your opinion about this program at airnsdtalks@gmail.com.